And now, once your patient is ready, your patient has a cannula and it's connected to a bag of saline, and then your patient should have 12 lead EKG and will be connected. Your technologist will give you the Lexi scan or the regadenoson, will pull it out, and then we'll have to prime it. After it's primed, he will give it to the physician. And to do this, I usually connect it. I take out some air, make sure that this is open, and I inject this over 10 seconds. After you have injected the regadenoson, your technologist will be preparing the technetium. And then he will inject it into the patient's cannula. Make sure that he will obstruct this so that the nuclear material does not go back to the saline. Instead, it will go through the cannula. And you should be doing the same thing when you're injecting the regadenoson. After you are done with the test, just like the treadmill, hit test end. And then you have to answer yes. Then the screen will show up and you have to answer as appropriate. So reason for termination, just leave it open. Resting EKG, you answer. Functional capacity, you have to say, could not be adequately assessed. Heart rate response, usually is gonna be attenuated. Blood pressure response, some of them have a blunted response or they get hypotensive. Chest pain, none. Arrhythmias, none. SE changes, none. And the overall impression, you just leave it as it is. And in the conclusion, you can say patient became hypotensive or so, and then click OK. In the spec, we don't usually appreciate much tachycardia as we see in dobutamine stress tests. So that's why this one, you might just write it down or say same or no change. After you click OK, you go to print and you hit print.